Assalamu alaikum everyone. Well, we're talking about risk. Risk is at times held back because of a sin you're committing. So we have to make sure and put all the effort to see that we quit sinning, we quit the sin. And inshallah, when Allah is happy, He's gonna give us our risk back and give us a lot of barakat in our risk. If you think that you already have a lot of everything and it's okay if you sin, it's not, you know, Allah is still gonna hold back your risk, irrespective of how much you have. This is why when you seek Allah's forgiveness, He's going to grant you sustenance and He is going to give you a lot. Ask Allah to forgive you all day, 100 times a day, and He will give you sustenance. Sustenance means blessing and barakat, what Allah gives you. Imagine having so much and having no barakat, and someone having so little and so much barakat. Especially barakat in what we buy. Imagine you end up buying something that is cheap but very, very beautiful. It serves the purpose, it's durable. It's gonna last, and at times you end up buying something which is very, very expensive and it doesn't last. Come on, let us not fool ourselves by saying that it's under warranty, it's under guarantee. You know how it is. Make dua to Allah when you select things like, oh Allah, you've given me so much, thank you so much, bismillah, before you buy anything. Example, you're buying a house or you're buying something which is valuable, and just keep Allah in between before you pick up anything, or before you start any business, or you buy any materialistic thing, because that is something which is very important. At times you see ke, you know, something has went wrong and you're like, oh my God, somebody's kept an evil eye on this, or somebody's jealous of it. No, nobody's jealous, my brother and sister. It's you who are jealous. You are staying in a house where you've not even prayed Salatul Fajr and you expect to have barakat in that house. How is that even possible? As-salatu khairun minan naum. I'm sure everyone must have heard this so many times. And this is the first effect of sin. What is the second effect of sin? What is the other effect of sin? That you end up forgetting everything that you know, especially in terms of your knowledge. You'll end up saying, oh, I've kept this somewhere and I don't remember where it is kept. Oh, I had this is what I had planned, but I don't remember what exactly the plan is. So in at the end of it, you end up forgetting everything that is beneficial in terms of knowledge. And now you've suddenly started forgetting everything. You've forgotten this, you've started forgetting that. Why? Because of ilm. Al ilmu nurun. Ilm is the light. You know, and that is something that is snatched away from you because you're drowning yourself into sin and you are not even ready to come back and repent. And there is no repentance. You don't regret your sins. You don't regret doing something wrong. You don't regret following the path of shaitan or your nafs. So that is something that is snatched away from you, which you need the most. So if you want to remember what you thought and you want to have a better memory and a better knowledge in terms of deen, in terms of everything, remember to seek forgiveness from Allah, because Allah is the most merciful and most forgiving. He is always ready to welcome you back. So my brothers and sisters, try and, you know, stay away from sin. Try and stay away even from the thought of sin, because it's going to take away loads of barakat from your life. So do lots of istighfar and do your namaz. Pray to Allah, tell Him that, you know, this is what I've done, you know everything, I'm admitting, I'm wrong, I have sinned, I regret it and I want to stop it, I'm inshallah never going to turn back to that sin. Ya Allah, help me, solve my problems, you know, I have no one but you, and that's the fact that we have no one but Allah, and to you is my return. So I want you to forgive me for my sin and just accept me and make me a better person, and inshallah Allah will forgive you.